What's going on, everybody? It's Jeff here. Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we are going to be talking about AMC. It is Monday. Currently, the stock is down about 3.5%. We knew the hedge funds were going to come out with guns blazing, giving it everything they got. Utilization has dropped less than 0.5%. Shares on loan have dropped, which means they have returned them. Okay, the price action has been red for the last 5 days. This is an important week with a lot of events happening, and I'm making this video because a lot of people have reached out to me showing some concern. They got a little restless, a little bit of anxiousness, and a little bit of impatience, which is understandable, guys. We've been holding the stock for a long period of time, and it's not easy. Nobody ever said holding a stock was easy. I've been holding Apple and Tesla for a long period of time through market corrections, company changes. It's up, 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 and gut-wrenching, red, red, red. It happens. It's a part of investing in the stock market, and it's not just with AMC stock, okay? But in this video, I want to try to calm some of your fears, and I'm going to give you a very, very short-sighted perspective on this stock, because I feel like everybody always talks about the broader view and where it could potentially go, and I just want to give you a short-sighted perspective compared to what else is going on in the stock market, because I know a lot of you guys, okay, who have money tied up in AMC, invested in AMC. Sometimes you think to yourself, am I missing out on other plays? All right. And first of all, you never want to think you're missing out, because there's always plays to add. There's times you're going to get out of a stock and it's going to shoot up right after you got out of it. Okay. And in times you're going to get in a stock, all right, after it's already run up and it's going to sell off. All a part of investing, guys. But I want to talk about what is going on this week and then give you guys a very short-sighted perspective to help calm some of your fears. Just know that we are sitting at a good point, okay? Yes, from where it was, you know, a little over a month ago, sitting at that $14 level, we are down almost 50% from that level. We popped up to that $12 level, and we're still down about 25%. But we can't go backwards. We can only look forwards, okay? So stick around, guys. You're not going to want to miss this. For those of you new to the channel, all I ask is that you hit that like button and subscribe and join the family. And if you're interested in joining our private community, first link in the description. We have hundreds of members that talk stocks, strategies all day long. We have a bunch of individuals who are absolutely killing it. I am proud of, happy that each and every one of you are a part of this community. Absolutely awesome. So if you're interested, guys, come check it out. We'd love to have you. Let's get into the video, guys. First off, I want to point this out. We talked about this is the financial services meeting that is set to happen. This is going to be their third meeting talking about the third committee hearing, talking about market volatility. The first one was on February 18th. It involved the CEO of Robinhood, Citadel, Melvin, other Reddit users, you know, DFV himself, continued on March 17th to talk a little bit more about it. All right. And then they are continuing. It was supposed to be this Thursday, May 6th. I just read this article as well. They changed it to Friday, May 7th, still happening this week. And the number one thing, whether you know what they're going to talk about, whether you've been following this or not, the number one important thing about this, guys, I cannot stress this enough, is bringing the attention, okay, to market transparency. Right. And whether you're new to investing or you've been investing for a little while, whether this helps us in the short term, as we all want it to, okay, it is going to help us in the long term. The days of hedge funds sweeping through, manipulating the market, are slowly going to fizzle away. It might not be something that happens overnight, because they, you know, the SEC needs to look at this on a really broader, you know, view and a bird's eye view, and see how it affects the entire economy, as well as all the citizens, okay, and investors that invest in the, you know, United States stock market, guys. So, but this is going to be good news for us. Just keep that in mind. It might not just be as quick as we want it to be, all right? But this is happening this week. We also have the shareholders, the shareholders meeting happening tomorrow, all right, which anything that's talked about in the shareholders meeting that is a positive news will be a good catalyst for AMC, as well as earnings happening this Thursday, okay? So before we get into the charts, before I can just give you guys a little bit of brief overview, I want to talk about this. There still is 3-to-1 options volume coming in on AMC, the call to put ratio. The volume, however, the overall volume has decreased a little bit. I had talked about this in a lot of prior videos. I hope you guys have watched it, talking about hedge funds abusing their in the money options, and they do it in order to hide their short positions. Okay, well, that volume has decreased dramatically, and I believe that's in a direct correlation happening because, as retail investors, are still investing by buying and holding stocks and buying the same amount of call options have. That's what I see from an upside perspective. Still a lot of positive value. Next thing I want to talk about, I think I'd mentioned this to you guys. This is just a screenshot I had taken off my Ortex. Shares on loan have decreased a little bit. It is still very, very high. Percent free flow on loan as well has decreased because of that as well. Days to cover is starting to increase. Like I said, that goes off the 65-day volume average, okay, which as we know lately has been much, much less where that 65-day is. Good to know. Cost to borrow has decreased. We saw a huge in the 20s, okay, percent cost to borrow. However, the current is still above where it was 7 days ago, and utilization has dropped just a quarter of percent. So really, really not much to go by. Last thing I'm going to talk about, like I said, before we get into the charts, is guys, this is through Fintel, but you can pull this up in many other places. These are the 13F filings, okay, which have to do with the institutions share positions, okay, what their current holdings are. If you can look down here, just take a quick glimpse on what it's been. This is the 29th, 30th. There's a lot of action going on in AMC stock, okay? Look at the amount of green. These are institutions adding to their position, holding their position, increasing their position, whatever you want to call it, guys. Green is good, okay? And even to take a broader look at this red, these are positions, look, 0, 0, 0, 0, that have already been closed out and just continually updated or updated again or not updated since. These are 0. So institutions are still holding AMC stock. There's one thing I've learned, okay, investing in the stock market. Actually, there's a few things I've learned. But one of the main things I've learned, to be honest with you guys, is these institutions, it's a little bit different now with the way the internet works and social media. But when I started investing in 2006, 2007, all right, even go into 2011, 2012, and you know those earlier years of my investing career, whatever the institutions knew was more than what we knew. And yes, the internet has changed it. Yes, social media has changed it. But that gives me some peace in mind, okay, that the institutions still believe where the stock is going. Now, I'm only talking about this in a very short-term perspective. I don't want to give any idea of where this stock, you know, it could potentially. I've tried to be really clear in my videos, guys. I do hold a position in AMC stock. To some, it might be a good size position. However, when it comes to relativeness to my portfolio, it is not a large percent of my portfolio, guys. Okay, so let's take a look at the charts. I talked about this before. We were looking for some of that consolidation to happen, guys, and it looks like we're starting to find that. And as you can see, let me go to the 30-day chart. As you can see, guys, this was insanely strong support. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe 8 touch points on this just over $9 level of support, okay? So if you've rode it through now, you've already rode through the high of $14. Sure, we all wish potentially we could have sold at the 14 and bought back in on the 9 if you're only playing for a short term, okay? You all always have those, you know, those thoughts that go through your mind. All right, but if you've held through all this time, we are on a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 day, you know, red, 5 days of red. Okay. Also, we are where the support is, guys. We are 5%, 50 cents, maybe not even, guys, 50 cents, 5% away from hitting that really, really strong sign of support. All right. So, what I've also learned is you want to sell when it's going up, not when it's going down. All right. And granted, guys, everybody, please, and you know, take investing and do investing into your own hands and your own due diligence. I don't want to tell anybody what to do. However, at this point, guys, we are very close to support. And if you're looking to even get back to where we were, that's a 33% increase. Okay. So even just giving you guys a really, really short-term perspective of where the stock could go, what could happen, especially with what's going on this week. I hope this video can just calm some of your fears. All right. Calm some of your anxiety. I see a lot of you reaching out to why I'm making this video. Okay, I know some of you guys have those, you know, that locked out mentality where it's not going to bother you at all. And some people don't, and that's okay because we're human and we're all different. But, all right, give you a short-term perspective, guys. Don't give up on the stock because it's still got some turnaround to happen. But in the end, guys, you got to do what's right for yourself, your family, your portfolio, your financial situations, everything. But that's it for this video, guys. See you in the next one.